I'm Sai Kumar. And today I'm going to discuss about the antenna and wave propagation. In this antenna and wave propagation concept, antenna and wave propagation. In this subject, antenna and wave propagation, today I'm going to discuss about what are the different what is the basic definition of the antenna? What are the different parameters of the antenna? What are the basic parameters of the antenna and the fixed parameters of the antenna, which should be met by the antenna for the proper performance and proper radiation of the antenna. So, antenna, when we are going about the definition of the antenna, before that, we have to know what is meant by electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave, EM wave. EM wave is nothing but a wave which consists of both electric field and magnetic field component, both perpendicular to each other. So in this electromagnetic wave, electric field, if you consider electric field along x y direction and magnetic field along x direction, and the resultant from will be root over e square plus h square. This is the resultant which will propagate along z direction. It will propagate along z direction. So in a similar manner, you can take either magnetic field along y direction and electric field along x direction. Electric field along x direction. Then also along z direction, the propagation will be root over e square plus h square. The component will be root over e square plus h square. So always electric field and magnetic field will be perpendicular to each other. So these electromagnetic waves are made to propagate in through a particular medium like a waveguide. If you take a medium like waveguide or a transmission line or a transmission line, these electromagnetic waves will be exhibiting different types of properties. That means these electromagnetic waves will be propagated only when there is an acceleration inside the particular medium through which it is getting propagated. So when there is no acceleration, when there is no movement of the current, that means if the current is completely uniform along that particular medium, electromagnetic waves cannot propagate. So electromagnetic waves will be propagated when there is a fluctuation in the charge. That means some oscillation should be generated. When there is oscillation generated, because of that fluctuation in the charge, the electromagnetic waves can be propagated. If it is a straight line, if you consider a straight line, if you consider a straight line, if the current is uniform along this straight line, then also electromagnetic waves cannot propagate. Because of this uniformity, it cannot propagate. But if in a curved path, if it is a curved path like or a bended path like this, in this movement, electromagnetic waves can propagate. Because of that non-uniformity of the structures, electromagnetic waves can propagate even though current is uniform. So in a straight line, in a straight path or in a straight conductor, in a straight transmission line or a wire, electromagnetic waves can propagate with the non-uniformity in the current. That means with some acceleration or deacceleration of the movement of the electromagnetic wave, the waves will get propagated. Once these waves are propagated, then we have to direct this antenna. We should know at this point what is an antenna. Antenna is nothing but a transducer. It is a transducer which is used for transition. It is used as a transistor, transition state. It is used as a transition device for transition, for making the transition from waveguide structures or a guided medium. You can call it as a guided medium to the unguided medium. That means if the waves, electromagnetic waves, are being transit in a transit state from guided medium to the unguided medium through these antenna structures. So antennas are hollow metallic structures. They are hollow metallic structures which are designed for transmitting or receiving the electromagnetic waves. They are designed for transmitting or receiving the electromagnetic waves. Okay, so these antennas are used for transmitting the electromagnetic waves or receiving the electromagnetic waves. So at this point of time, we should know that what actually happening in an antenna. So in antenna, the voltage applied to the transmitter, in this antenna will be converted to electromagnetic wave. It will be converted to electromagnetic wave, and this is propagated through the free space, and these waves will be propagated through the free space, and the waves, when they are propagated through the free space, and again at the receiver of the antenna, again this, the same electromagnetic wave will be reconverted back to the voltage. This will be converted back to the voltage. So now it is used as a transducer, where it is converting the voltage applied by the transmitter side to the electromagnetic wave, and the electromagnetic wave is again reconverted to the voltage at the receiver side. And this antenna, it should follow some basic parameters. When antennas are designed, they should follow the basic parameters. So now let's know what are the different basic parameters of the antenna. So the basic parameters of the antenna, what it should follow is impedance matching. Impedance matching is the basic parameter which it should follow. Okay, impedance matching. Basic parameters. Of antenna. Basic parameters of antenna. The basic parameters of antenna, the first basic parameter is impedance matching. Impedance matching. For example, if they are from the transmitter side, you are applying some voltage here at the transmitter, and the signals are being propagated into the free space. And again, it is received at the receiver. The signals are transmitted. So here, you will be using the guided medium, and you will be connecting it to the antenna. It is connecting it to the antenna. These waves will be propagated through this guided. This is the source. And if this source is connected to the guided medium, this is called guided medium. This is called transmission line. This is the transmission line, and this is the source, and this is the antenna. This antenna, it will propagate the electromagnetic wave, which is sinusoidal in nature, and here the movement of the electrons, the electromagnetic waves, they will be either having a TE mode propagation or a TM mode propagation. It can be of any type of mode of propagation can be there, and these waves will be propagated, and now it will be transmitting through the antennas, where it will be having a propagation like this through the antennas, and now they will be propagated through the free space. These waves will be propagated through the free space. When these waves are propagated in the free space, here there should be an impedance matching between the source to the transmission line and from the transmission line to the antenna. So when there is no impedance matching between the source and the transmission line, impedance is not properly matched, then there will be a standing wave ratio provided, will be developed. That means reflections will be generated. So whatever the signal given here should be transmitted to the antenna, and the antenna should radiate it into the free space, and from the free space it should be received to the receiver, and again the receiver should transmit to the outer section of the receiver. That means receivers where the signal being received. But when there is a mismatch occurs, standing waves will be produced. These standing waves will be affecting the generator. This will be affecting the generator. Why? Because the signals will be retransmitted back to the source again. Whatever the signals being transmitted should be received by the receiver. But what happens here, because of this impedance mismatch, the signals will again received by the source, and it will affect the transmitter. So what these standing waves which are produced will be very disadvantage to the antenna transmitter. So what we will use is, we will use this stub matching technique. So we will use the stub matching technique for in transmission line for removing these standing waves. We will use stub matching technique for removing the standing waves. So this stub matching is nothing but we have to give the voltage and the susceptance values which are equal in magnitude but opposite in nature. We should give a equal in magnitude but opposite in nature, which is of the equal. For example, some dB reflection is observed here. You have to give that the same dB output here, the stub matching, but it is of the negative value, so that the both will be cancelled out and the reflections will be eliminated. This is called stub matching technique, which is generally used in antennas for reducing this reflections. So generally, the voltage standing wave ratio, it should be maintained between 1 to infinity. This is the voltage standing wave ratio which should be there in the antennas for proper transmission. And for this antenna, ideally the voltage standing wave ratio of the value of 2 is preferable for proper transmission from the source to the destination. So general values of voltage standing wave ratio is from 1 to infinity. Okay, so now this impedance matching should be done. That means ZL should be equals to Z0. It should be terminated with Z0. That means the load impedance should be terminated with the characteristic impedance. If load impedance is not properly terminated with the characteristic impedance, then standing waves will be produced, which will be affecting the transmitter section. So standing waves will be produced. These standing waves will affect the transmitter. So this is the first basic parameter which should be matched. Another thing is frequency of operation. The frequency of operation. So in antennas, we will be looking for the main thing is frequency of operation. We already know that as the frequency is higher, the signals can penetrate more into the free space, where f equal to b is given by f equal to c by lambda. So higher the frequencies, shorter the wavelengths, and more the penetration of the signals into the free space. So the faster the data rate and faster the information transmission rate will be. So that's why the frequency of the antenna is very much important. Here, when the frequency is high, what happens? When the frequency is high, the diameter of the antenna will be reduced. This is the main advantage of higher frequency signals. What happens? The diameter will get reduced. When diameter is reduced, you can accommodate that antenna at any, you can embed the antenna. So you can embed the antenna to the any surface. You can embed the antenna to the any surface. So if you are operating at a megahertz frequency, for example, you are operating at 300 megahertz. You are operating at 300 megahertz. Then, what is the diameter of the antenna it is required? Depending upon the formula, you may require some meters of length of antenna. At 300 megahertz, if you want to transmit the data, you require some around meters of diameter of antenna. Okay, aperture surface of the antenna requires in meters. If you operate the same information, if you want to transmit the same information in gigahertz, for example, if you want to transmit at 3 gigahertz, it will be in centimeters. Your antenna size will be reduced. It will be in centimeters. So once the antenna size is getting decreased, the diameter of the antenna is getting decreased into centimeter, you can embed that antenna into any area and at any surface, and it is flexible. And here losses can also be minimized. You can eradicate so many losses, like losses through the atmosphere, okay, losses through the devices itself. So many losses can be eliminated. So that's why, so operating at higher frequencies are very much important. So what is the wavelength of that antenna? They are shorter wavelengths. As the frequency increases, the wavelength will get decreased. So the wavelength of the antenna, next parameter is wavelength. As frequency is getting increased, wavelength is getting decreased. That means they are getting shorter, shorter waves. They are called as shorter waves, and the wavelengths will be centimeters, centimeter waves. So the generally